If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification.
Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in GATE Power System series. So today we'll be solving from question number 16 to question number 20. Okay, then let's try to solve these questions.
Okay, student, if you come to question number 16, a surge of 20 kilovolt magnitude travels along a lossless cable towards its junction with two identical lossless over a transmission line. The inductance capacitance of the cables are given and the transmission line is also given. The magnitude of the voltage as the junction due to the surges. So this one, I think you know that chapter, reflection coefficient and the line ending with at a junction point. So the characteristics impedance of this line, these are important for you. So you do along with that formula. So if you calculate, this is the suppose cable and these two are overhead lines and they are identical, so same. So what is the characteristics impedance of ZC? So it is given as 4 milli Henry and 5 micro, 0.5 micro. So if you do this one, L by C, ZC is equal to, and C is your 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 6. So if you do it, you will find it is 28.28. And both these overhead line are same. Again for Z it will be, L is here 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 0.015 into 10 to the power minus 6. So it is 316.28. Now once you have this one, now the transmitted wave, the formula is that V is equal to original voltage that multiplied by 2 by ZC, then divided by 1 by ZC. So there are different cases, terminating with infinite open line, terminated with a short line, terminated with another impedance, 316.28, 1 by 316.28. So if you do it, you will get it 33.93 kV. That is your option D. Now if you come to 17, ABCD parameter of a three-phase overhead transmission lines are given. At no load conditions, shunt inductance inductive reactor is connected at the receiving end of the line to limit the receiving end voltage to be equal to the sending end voltage. So both these magnitudes are equal. The ohmic, the receiving end, sending end voltage, their magnitude, they are equal. They have so told you. Okay. The ohmic value of the reactors are. So at the receiving end, what they are doing? So they are equal means equal. Not only magnitude everywhere. Just given you equal means, you will take it Vs is equal to Vr. Means along with that angle also. Okay, so let me take it in this way. Suppose this is my VSIS. And this was a VRIS. So it is connected with a shunt reactor. Okay. So it is made such a way said that VS is equal to VR. These reactors are connected so that your sending and receiving end voltage should be same value. So you know the formula VS equal to AVR plus BIR. So this is given VS. A is also given 0.9 into VR is also VS. B is also given 200 at an angle of 90. And IR is nothing but VR by this impedance. Suppose this is reactor, inductive reactor, so XL. So that is BS, VR divided by, so VR and VS is equal, that's why I am writing this one. So VS get cancelled, finally you are left with 1 is equal to 0.9 plus, this one you know, this will be a 90 degree, so 90 will get cancelled because it is XL angle 90. So it will be only 200 by XL. So if you solve it, you will get your XL is equal to 2000, that is your option B. Now if you come to 18, a generalized circuit constant of a 220 kV rated voltage medium length transmission line ABCD are given. If the load at the receiving end is this at 220 kV with a power factor of this, the magnitude of the line to line sending end voltage. Okay, line to line sending end voltage, you have to be very careful about this. So whatever formula you have, this is for per phase values. This VS, VR, these are all per phase. So AVR plus BIR. Okay. So let me calculate what will be its VR. This is VS, I don't know. Let me put this value 0.936 plus or angle 0.98. You put it this. So this calculation you have to be very careful. This now it will come. This angle phasor calculations into VR will be 220 into 10 to the power 3 divided by root 3. Let me take V as an angle of reference, VR as a reference voltage. This is VR, so it is angle 0. Y divided by root 3 because nothing is mentioned, that means it is line voltage, so you convert it into phase voltage. Transmission line by default you always take it is star connected. So every time they have given 220 between phase to phase given, so per phase it will be 220 value 3. Okay. And in case of current it will be per phase current, that will be your IL and I phase will be same because I am considering it is to be star current. You assume your transmission line always to be star current.
Okay.
So you, what will be your IR? IR will be equal to power is equal to 50 into 10 to the power 6 root 3 VLIL. VL is 220 into IL, I don't know, that is your IL here, and then cos phi is given 0.9. And there will be an angle because it is lagging, so minus cos inverse 0.9. Because I will be, because this is VR, then I will be here. This is VR, this will be your IR. So this is the angle, cos inverse 0.9, because power factor is 0.9. So if you do this one, I think you will get here. And for B, if I put this value, B is equal to 142.76.4 multiplied by this value IR, whatever you have calculated here. This value, I think you will get 145.79 at an angle minus 25.84. These calculations, you have to be very careful because in the exam, I am saying this, because it is okay because if you multiply it polar form, then it will be angle will be added, angle. But finally, when you open it, because this one will be some angle, because at angle you cannot add. So if you add these two in calculator, you might be doing it very easily, but this polar form rectangular form problem will not be available in that screen calculator in gate exam. So you have to be very careful. If you need to convert it, you need to convert it into rectangular cos sine using, then you have to add real and imaginary, then you have to do again conversion to back to polar form. So this you have to be very careful, these conversions. I am saying it because I have experience for doing mistakes in exam or in these calculations. So do these calculations in your hand. Hand means that not changing it to polar to rectangular, rectangular to polar in your calculator. In calculator, you directly write this angle, this multiplied by this angle, this. Don't do this. You, into is okay because into this and add. But if you need to add, suppose 5 angle 30, you need to add these two. In calculator you can do it, but here that will be not, in that case gate exam it will not be available. So you have to convert it into real imaginary using cos sine. Then you add real imaginary, then whatever you got, you convert it into again polar. It will be something r plus something x plus iy. Then how to again convert it real polar? R will be this one, angle will be 10 inverse y by x. Again, when you are writing 10 inverse, you have to be careful which quadrant it is. So you can check the complex number videos, basic lectures, where I have discussed all these things to convert it from rectangular to polar. I will give a link. If needed, you can go through that. So this is your VS, but this is your phase voltage. But they have asked you to find line-to-line voltage, line-to-line sending end voltage. So that will be 133.24 into root 3. If you do, you will get 230.78. That is your option C. See, this is also is in your option. 133.23 was also in option. Next, if you come to 19, the parameters of the transposed over a transmission line are given this one, XS, MS, XM, the positive sequence. This, I think you know, sequence network. For a transmission line, what is your positive sequence network? It is XS minus XM. And what is zero sequence? It is XS plus 2XM. So these are the formulas for transmission line. If it is a properly symmetrical transposed one, so it will be 0.4 minus 0.1, that is 0.3, and this one is 0.4 plus 2 into 0.1, that is 0.6. So 0.3 and 0.6, that is your option D. So next, if you can come to 20, the concept of electrically short, medium, long line is primarily based on nominal voltage, no physical length, yes, wavelength, no, power transmission over line, no, this is actually physical length, and on the basis of physical length. Why I am saying physical length? Because on the basis of length, the effect of capacitance is considered. So you have seen one more example where length was given 50, but frequency was increased to 500. So your 50 kilometer looked like 500 kilometer because your effect of capacitance is now cannot be neglected. So that's why it is actually basically what is the length of that line and what frequency you are operating properly, if I say. Because on that basis, your C will be considered. You will think whether you will consider C or not. If you consider it, whether you consider it lumped C or distributed C. So that's why we have here it is physical length of this line. That is your option B.
If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.